Hello everybody and welcome to Season 2, Race 5 of the NASCAR Legend Series. As you see here, we have all 18 of our drivers lined up for the next race here, coming from Elmer's Speedway. It's a pretty unique style oval with a flick in the backstretch, a little right-left flick. And then turn 3 and 4, the outside lane is generally dominant because of that flick and where pit road is. While 1 and 2, you want to be on the inside to hit that corner as precisely as possible. Again, a very interesting racetrack. Very unique pit road too, as it's got a hairpin in the pit road. So that'll be interesting to see if that comes into play. Fuels might be stretched today because it's a decently long race for this track as all the cars roll off. Starting lineup, row 1 is Richard Petty and Dale Jarrett. Row 2 is Kyle Busch and Mark Martin. Row 3 will be Darrell Waltrip and Jeff Gordon. Row 4 is Denny Hamlin and Rusty Wallace. Row 5 is Kevin Harvick and Jimmy Johnson. Kevin Harvick had a fast car in practice. Row 6 is Michael Waltrip and Ryan Newman. Row 7 is Joey Logano and Kurt Busch. Row 8 is going to be Tony Stewart and Dale Earnhardt Jr. And rounding out the field in row 9 is Matt Kenseth and Brad Keselowski. Now let's get down to today's race facts. There are going to be 15 laps run at Elmer Speedway, which might stretch out the fuel a little bit. The stages are going to end at lap 5, 10, and 15 today. And the halfway point of the season is today, as this is race number 5. And the green flag's in the air. Richard Petty gets a good push on the bottom by Kyle Busch. And those two drivers will take the 1-2 slide, and there's a wreck on the backstretch already. Quickly into catastrophe here. Four-car pileup on the backstretch where the track narrows. It looks like Dale Jarrett was trying to not get pushed into the grass, which resulted in Denny Hamlin going up into the wall, collecting the first four cars behind him, blocking the track completely, separating two groups of cars under the red flag conditions. And we are under red flag conditions, so we will be back as soon as the track clears up. Alright, and we are back. The yellow flag is now in the air as all the cars roll off. We will resume this race on lap number 4 here at Elmer Speedway. Now, the green flag is back in the air. Richard Petty will lead them down. Kevin Harvick gets a great jump on the inside there. Goes all the way down to the grass almost. And is up to second. Dale Jarrett's now in third. But Kyle Busch just passed him for third. As he has a really fast car today. Now, goes down low, really low. And Kevin Harvick, and Harvick's in the grass. Just saves the car. Richard Petty will come home and win stage 1. Kyle Busch in 2nd. Kevin Harvick 3rd. Now, can Kyle Busch pass Richard Petty here? He looks like he has a more dominant car. He has a great car. Really fast car. Can't pass him on the inside in 3 and 4. He's going to get a big boost by Kevin Harvick on the backstretch, though. And really gets through. Turn 1 and 2 well. Gets around the outside of Richard Petty there. And will go to the lead on the front stretch here. Lap 8 of 15. The cars are so close to the wall, the camera's shaking there. As Kevin Harvick goes for 2nd, and there's a big wreck in turn 1. Turn 1 continuing down to turn 2. Massive pileup. Tony Stewart gets into Dale Jr. Ryan Newman gets involved. Kurt Busch can't see, can't slow down. Hard hit into the 20 of Tony Stewart. And by this point, Rusty Wallace has lost control, slides in there as well. 5-car pileup there. That is not fun to see, as Ryan Newman's getting taken off, as you see there. And some cars are taking this opportunity to come down pit road. Kevin Harvick will win the stage as a result of that. And Kyle Busch is one of the cars who's coming down for pit road. The cars who stay out might be close on fuel. That'll be interesting to watch. And it looks like Kyle Busch will win the race off of pit road. And he will take over the 5th position. Can he get back up the field with only 4 laps to go? That'll be a very interesting situation here. Now, the green flag is back in the air. Kevin Harvick will get the jump on Richard Petty. Richard Petty comes down the block, already advancing Kyle Busch. As Kyle Busch is stuck in 3rd there off of a great run on the restart. Kevin Harvick really pushing it hard here. Richard Petty seems like he's starting to let it fade back. He might be concerned about fuel. That means Kyle Busch is going to have a chance to catch him. He's going to maybe try to go to the inside there. No, he can't do it. And now he's going to go all the way to the apron here. Richard Petty almost puts him in the grass. Kyle Busch will survive it, though. And he only has 1 more lap to pass Kevin Harvick. Does he have enough time? Does Harvick have enough fuel to make it all the way around? Now Harvick out of 2. And he's out of fuel. He's slow on the backstretch. Kyle Busch will pass him on the inside. So does everybody else. Everyone's getting around cleanly. And Kyle Busch will win 2 straight here at Elmer Speedway. as Kevin Harvick, so close to winning, will come home last out of the active cars. See, just ran out of fuel, pushed it too hard early. Had to do something to get to do something to not let Kyle Busch win. He had a really dominant car today. The crowd cheers. You can hear some boos back there, too, as he burns it out down the front stretch and performs his signature bow in front of these Elmer's fans. Kyle Busch is your winner today at Elmer Speedway, Race 5. He's now won two races this season. He's on a tear right now, two in a row, actually, which puts him in the first spot. The second spot is actually belonging to Richard Petty, third Dale Jarrett. Fourth is Jeff Gordon, last week's winner. Ryan Newman, the first winner, is all the way back in sixth. Darrell Waltrip's in fifth. That's where all your notable drivers have ended up. Now, the next week, we will be going to Pearl City Speedway, a really unique road course that has a big, long, curving front stretch, and then really tight corners. Tire wear will be a big issue there, as this track is actually somewhat old. So tire wear will be a big issue, as we are very excited to see what that track delivers. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching this race. I told you the quality would get better, and here it is. I hope you enjoy it. Yeah, it was a really fun race to make. One of my favorite tracks on the schedule, probably. But thank you, everybody, so much for watching this race, and I hope you all have a good night.